on the very chilly side this morning, on the brink of cold even. A lot of places hitting the mid to upper 40s, with a few spots feeling like the low 40s earlier this morning. But the good news is we do warm up. Very pleasant conditions later this afternoon. 64 by noon, 73 by 3 o'clock with lots of sunshine. But temperatures as we head into the sunset hour in this evening quickly dropping. 62 by around 6 o'clock, mid to low 50s potentially as we head into the 9 o'clock hour. I do think this is going to be a little bit on the lower note. I feel like we're going to be in the mid to upper 50s instead of low 50s, but North Mississippi could potentially see low 50s as we head into the later part of the evening. Heading up to Davis Wade Stadium this afternoon, Mississippi State taking on Texas A&M Aggies, kickoff at 3 o'clock. Temperatures staying in the mid to upper 60s with lots of sunshine, cooler in the shade, but overall a very comfortable game day for up in Stark Vegas. Then Ole Miss hitting the road, going to Donald W. Reynolds Stadium over in Fayetteville, Arkansas, taking on the Razorbacks, kickoff at 2:30. Again, very sunny conditions. Temperature is pretty comfortable, upper 60s, low 70s. But the really big difference is the wind. They're going to be seeing a wind advisory up until 5 o'clock this afternoon. Gusts at times could range between 30 to 35 miles an hour. Back here at home tonight, temperatures not going to be as cold, but we're still going to be on the chillier note. 52 degrees with a few passing clouds possible. And the wind picks up out of the south tomorrow afternoon. Comfortable, fantastic conditions. A little bit more cloud cover for tomorrow. Temperatures reaching the upper 70s. And low 80s. Quick look at the tropics. We have one tropical wave worth noting. A very high chance that we could be seeing this as a subtropical depression or a storm by the end of the weekend or the start of the week. And this is going to be named Epsilon most likely. We only have two names away from tying the record of 2005. If we end up reaching a named storm of Eta, then we will be beating the record for 2005. So we've been staying active in the mid-Atlantic as well as the Caribbean, but the Gulf of Mexico has been staying quiet for the past couple of days, and we'll continue to do so thanks to multiple cold fronts that have been moving across the eastern part of the United States. So this weekend, very mild conditions, lots of sunshine to go around. But as we head to the early part of next week and pretty much all of next week, we're going to be warming on up. Temperatures well above average for this time of year. Lots of sunshine to go around as well. And the humidity is also expected to bump back up. We'll be seeing dew points returning into the 60s. So overall tolerable next week, but we'll still be seeing some muggy conditions as we head into the middle to end of the week. But as we go into the next couple of days, here's what we're going to be expecting. Temperature is well above average for this time of year, not only along the eastern seaboard, but also for us here in Jackson. Temperatures are expected to be in the mid to low 80s next week, but we do have a little bit of a change up potentially in about a week and a half to 2 weeks in advance. This is a little too far out to give you this is exactly what's going to happen, but there has been a trend of some cooling air slowly moving towards the east and southeast over the next week and a half to 2 weeks. So something worth noting and monitoring as we go through the next couple of days. So here's your 7-day forecast for you. Temperatures again today, pretty nice and pleasant, 73 degrees for our high, chilly in the morning, and then temperatures going well above average for this time of year next week. Lows in the 60s, highs in the mid to low 80s. A few chances of some showers can't be ruled out by the middle part of next week, and then a cold front swings through the Magnolia State Friday, bringing a chance for a few thunderstorms.